Let them learn by experience. Let them be right until they realize they're wrong. And then show them how to do it right. Or you wouldn't be here unless you have the confidence and the knowledge to do the job. And in a nice way, be that representative of the club that gets the student excited and motivated about wanting to go out there and do it again. There's only four things they got to learn for the whole course: sailing into the wind, turning around, sailing with the wind behind them, and coming around again. Just those four things, and then you spend the rest of your life learning how to do it better.
Hi, how is everybody tonight?
Good.
How many of you are here with a significant other or a spouse that you plan to sail with? I have a phrase that I want you people to remember, and you can use it on each other whenever the occasion seems appropriate, and that is the boat still floating? Okay? Just keep that in mind. Is the boat still floating? And you will know when you need to help your spouse or partner. Very good time through this course and through the process of learning to sail. Not only are we going to be teaching you something most of you are completely unfamiliar with, we're going to be teaching it to you in a language most of you don't know how to speak. And that is all the nautical terminology. And we don't use the nautical terminology just to impress you or to confuse you. There are, although it's fun watching that too, there are very, very good reasons why everything related to a boat and the operation of it has a specific name that for the most part is not used in any other part of the world. So, as you sit there and listen, as we go through the class, you're going to hear a lot of words that you haven't heard before, or that you don't understand what the meaning is. Please stop and ask questions when things aren't clear to you. Can anybody out there identify the mass? The big stick. Exactly right. It's the pole in the middle of the boat that these sails hang from. Always going to be dependent on the speed of the wind, first of all. The second factor that determines the speed of the sailboat is the point of sail. And the third factor that influences the speed of the sailboat is how cleverly you can trim sails. If the wind is blowing 10 knots from this direction, your fastest point of sail is going to be a reach. actually the very fastest point of sale is a closed reach, providing you have your sails trimmed properly. And we will get into detail later on how you determine how the sails are trimmed properly.
As you saw how graceful I was. But I'll keep one hand for yourself and one hand for the bed. So hold on to something and just hold it. They are going to move. So it's going to happen a little bit. But